Look at all these great faces that we have here with us today. Thank you again all for coming. We hope you enjoy our virtual event. Also, please make sure that you are on mute so that we could all hear of our speeches and everything pretty good. And we're gonna get started. Relay for Life of Greater Pittston Virtual Event 2020. Now for our opening ceremonies with Isabella Mancini.
Welcome everyone to the 9th annual Relay for Life of Greater Pittston. We come together this weekend to participate in an event that spans the globe. Each year, more than 4 million people in over 20 countries take part in this global phenomenon and raise much needed funds and awareness to save lives from cancer. By participating today from your home, you are joining with millions of people worldwide fighting for a world without cancer. We would like to thank our event sponsors, Mitchell Cohen Orthodontics $500, DJ J. Lombardo $315, the Pittston Popcorn Company $250, the Tipsy Turtle Airport Pub $100, and the West Side Social Club with $100. This year's Relay Journey started back in October. During this journey to Relay, we participated in monthly fundraisers. They range from clothing sales to popcorn and fudge and pizza certificates. This year, our journey, we have raised a total of $13,161.43 so far, but we aren't done yet. Everyone on our committee has worked hard this year, but there is one person who keeps us all together. She commits many hours to this event and is our Relay for Life moderator. I would like to now introduce Ms. Bauman.
Thanks, Izzy. I also just want to remind everybody that you have until the end of this month if you want to see myself and Ms. Lizemnik get pied in the face on Facebook Live with real actual pies. We have to hit our goal of $20,000. So again, please post and share with all your family and friends, relayforlife.org/PA Greater Pittston, or share your own individual fundraising page. The more money we get, the closer we are to seeing pies in our faces. Now for our committee introductions. I'd like to introduce our incredibly hardworking committee who has given countless hours to make this whole event come together and have risen to the occasion on putting together this virtual event. This year's event chair is Isabella Mancini. Team development and mission delivery coaches are Emily Dietrich and Marissa Gubitoso. Fundraising and sponsorship co-leaders are Eleni Alfano, Isabella Latona, and Tom DeSoy. Survivorship co-chairs are Kylie Herbert, Gianna Ike, and TJ Connors. Luminaria co-chairs are Jaden Zaruha and Jessica Zaldonis. Our activities coordinators are Mia DeMarco, Abby Bartoli, Janelle Dudick, and John Florio. And lastly, our logistics coordinators are Isabella Latona and Alina Carabetta. I would now like to recognize the committee members who are seniors and will be leaving us this year. Thank you for all of your hard work and dedication to this great organization. You will be greatly missed. They are Isabella Mancini, Tom DeSoy, Kylie Herbert, TJ Connors, and Alina Carabetta. Again, thank you for all that you have done for us over the years. Now back to Izzy.
Relay for Life is an event in conjunction with the American Cancer Society. The event helps to heal, support, celebrate, and honor all those who have been affected by cancer in one way or another. I'm sure everyone here can say they have been greatly affected by cancer in some way. We all have specific people and reasons to be here, but we all share one goal. Our goal is to put an end to cancer, to find a cure, and to see no more suffering from it. We are here to celebrate life in a world with more birthdays. The theme of this year's event is Lights, Camera, Cure. There are many movies that tell a story on the real effects that cancer can do to a person and a family. In these movies, we see the pain and struggle cancer can cause, but we also see the fighting spirit of these brave individuals. Also in these movies, a community comes together to help them overcome cancer and to find a cure, just like we are doing with Relay for Life. Everyone here on this field takes for granted the little things in life, like not doing so great on a test or not being invited to go for food with friends. While kids our age and so many adults are battling cancer every day just to wake up the next morning so their bodies can go through chemo and radiation all over again. So as we are here today, let's take on cancer like a boss, fight to the finish. Let's use the force to guide us to the end game of cancer. We would like to welcome our teams that are participating with us this year. A Relay Story, A Walk to Remember, Venging for a Cure, Cancer and the Cure, Cancer Can't Sit With Us, Cancer in Custody, Fighting for the Future, Just Keep Curing, Kicking Cancer to Infinity and Beyond, School of Walk, Shrek Cancer, Team Determination for Hope, Terminators, Up with the Cure, and You've Got a Cure in Me. Let's take our first lap together from inside or outside your home. Take your phone along the walk with you and any of your family that is with you right now. The Relay for Life of Greater Pittston Virtual Event 2020 starts in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, start walking.
Hope when you take that jump, don't fear the fall. Hope when the water rises, you build the wall. Open the crowd screams out, screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad. You spend your days, but they all add up. And when the sun goes down, hope you raise your cup. Oh, I wish that I could witness all your joy and all your pain. But until my moment comes, I'll say, I swear I live every broken home. I swear I did it all.
Great job, everybody. Now on to Marissa and Emily for our mission moment.
Due to the outbreak of COVID-19, everyone's lives have been affected, but cancer has not stopped, so neither does the American Cancer Society. Not only has the association advocated and provided significant amounts of funding for cancer patients, but also the health systems, researchers, and regulators. Their funding to the National Institutes of Health helps to research and develop COVID-19 diagnostic tools, vaccines, and therapies. They have also helped support hospital capacity and cover healthcare providers' expenses. They are continually sharing vital information and guidance to keep patients safe and informed, and they are working to add video conferencing to the 24/7 cancer helpline to ensure patients and families get the answers they need and face-to-face discussions in a time of social distancing.
One of the American Cancer Society's biggest programs is Hope Lodge, which allows patients and their caregivers a place to stay while receiving treatment in another city. But this program has been recently shut down. These facilities are now being used as housing for healthcare workers battling the pandemic. This allows them to rest between shifts, isolate from their families, and have a place to stay overnight. COVID is much more dangerous to cancer victims and people undergoing chemotherapy because of their weakened immune systems, which is why the Society is also providing free testing to all patients. With the American Cancer Society's help and the use of their resources in different ways, they're committed to helping our communities as always. Money raised from our event will help support all the things ACS continues to do throughout this pandemic and after.
Thanks, girls, and thanks to the American Cancer Society for all that they do. Now on to Kylie and TJ for our survivor ceremony.
Welcome to this year's survivor ceremony. Thanks to the help of the American Cancer Society, there has been a drastic rise in the number of cancer survivors in the United States within the last decade. Relay for Life's goal is to help put an end to cancer once and for all.
A survivor is anyone who has been told the words, "You have cancer." Survivors give hope, strength, and motivation to numerous amounts of people. They are the warriors who show us to never stop fighting. They are the hometown heroes who bring faith and light into all of our lives. They give us the motivation to keep going, even when our worlds have turned upside down. Life changes when a person is told, "You have cancer." But the patient is only one of the people affected by the cancer.
Life also changes for those who care about and love the person with cancer. And life also changes for the person who will help the patient get through the cancer experience, the caregiver. I am so honored to be able to help celebrate the survivors and caregivers around the world and those who would have been here with us today at our 2020 Relay for Life Greater Pittston.
Our speaker today is Donna Renaro. She is a two-time, 19-year cancer survivor, and she is currently a case management nurse at the Wilkes-Barre General Hospital, working hard through this pandemic. She has recorded her story and experience to share with you today.
It was October 15th of 2001 when I went in for a breast biopsy. I have to admit I was really nervous, mainly because I never had any surgery done in the past. I wasn't really nervous about the result of the biopsy because no one in my family had ever had breast cancer. So I thought, I'll go in, I'll have this lump removed and go home. My surgery was done and I was in the recovery room drinking some juice, and I was just waiting for the doctor to come in to clear me to be discharged home. So while I was laying in my bed, I see my surgeon coming into the recovery room thinking he's going to tell me that I'm ready to go home. But I was so wrong. He came to my bedside and said to me, "They're calling this a cancer." I became hysterical, crying. My recovery room nurses were very close friends of mine because I myself am a nurse, and I had worked with them for many, many years, and they came over to console me. and to make me feel at least a little bit more comfortable. But once I was able to regain my composure, I was ready for discharge. My mother came back with me and I asked my mother what would happen to Ashley, my daughter, because at the time she was only 13 years old and she needed a mother to love her, help her, nurture her and raise her. And my mom just said to me, giving me a big hug and said, "We're gonna get through this." I only lived a short distance from the hospital, but the car ride home seemed like it was taking forever. No one said a word on the way home. It was so quiet, you could hear a pin drop. But I went through many surgeries, which included a breast lumpectomy with lymph node metastasis and dissection. And after this surgery, I went to seek a second opinion at Memorial Sloan Kettering Cancer Center and to obtain some other treatment options. I met with a wonderful breast cancer surgeon there who recommended bilateral mastectomies with reconstruction because of my young age. I agreed to the surgery and to the treatment, but I had already begun my chemotherapy and radiation, so they requested that I continue with that treatment and complete it before I had undergone the additional surgery and reconstruction. So after 8 rounds of chemotherapy and 35 radiation treatments, I was finally ready to undergo my surgery. This time I was really nervous because I was finally ready to be done with this whole cancer thing. And I felt that I wouldn't have to have any worries about a reoccurrence. My surgery was successful. I had a long recovery period. I was doing very well, having yearly scans and lab work and everything coming back clear. But 6 years later, I started having pain in my right thigh and nothing helped control the pain. So I contacted my primary doctor and who ordered an x-ray, which I had done while I was working that same day. So I'm on my unit and I see my pager go off and it was the radiology department calling me with the results of the x-ray. And the radiologist said to me, "I'm so very sorry to tell you this, but you have a lesion in your femur." Again, I become hysterical, called my closest work friend, Mary Ellen, who came to me for support in addition to getting the support of the nursing staff who I worked with for so many years. I called my oldest sister that day who had drove me home from the hospital and from work, and the next day had an appointment with my oncologist. From there, I went back to my radiation oncologist, back to more radiation treatments, 30 treatments later, pain-free, back to work doing well again. Only a year later, having more excruciating pain in my right femur, I wasn't able to walk or go to work. While waiting at home to hear from my oncologist, I was trying to do things for myself instead of always asking my daughter for help. I just wanted to try to give her a little bit of a break. So instead, I decided to go to the bathroom myself. Slowly walking to the bathroom, I go to the bathroom and I get back to the bedroom. And I lifted my leg up to get back into bed just when my femur fractured. Back to the hospital, many additional surgeries followed. But I'm happy to report no cancer reoccurrences in the last 10 years. I've been blessed with a beautiful, supportive daughter, two wonderful sisters, my best friend, Mary Ellen, who was always there to help and support me. My mom was my rock. She was always with me. She provided me with physical help that I needed, but the emotional support only a mother is capable of giving. Funds raised by the Relay for Life provide so many services for cancer patients who may not have a support system to help them during the treatment process. Without the great volunteers, especially my niece Amanda, who year after year volunteer their time to make these events possible, I would like to say thank you for all you've done for me and for all those who continue to fight this battle now and in the future. We couldn't be more proud of all that you do to help us in this fight against cancer.
Thank you, Donna, for sharing your story here with us today. You are truly an inspiration to why we keep doing this year after year.
We have all had our lives touched by cancer in some shape or form. We all relay for a loved one who has or has had cancer. The survivors are the hope for the American Cancer Society, and they are the hope that a cure will someday be found. At this time, we would like you to take victory lap inside or outside of your house for all of the survivors out there. Take your phone along the walk with you and any of your family that is with you right now while you listen to some inspiration from Sir Elton John.
rewind. I'm like the rig you hide behind that mask you use. And did you think this fool could never win? Well, look at me, I'm coming back again. I got a taste of love and a simple way. And if you need to know while I'm still standing, you just fade away. Don't you know I'm still standing, better than I ever been. Looking like a true survivor, feeling like a little kid. And I'm still standing after all this time, picking up the pieces of my life without you on my mind. I'm still standing.
Thanks to Kylie and TJ and to Donna for your great words of inspiration. Now on to our Luminare ceremony with Jessica and Jaden.
Welcome to the Luminare ceremony. Now is the time we remember the friends and family we have lost, honor those who have won the fight, and support those currently battling.
The American Cancer Society is the official sponsor of birthdays. And what is a birthday without a cake? And what is a birthday cake without candles? But this cake and these candles are not your typical cake and candles. They are very special because tonight we are remembering you, our loved ones we lost to this terrible disease.
You'll note that there are 12 candles on this cake, one for each of the months we have missed you. We missed you in January as the new year started and the snow covered the ground. We missed you in February. Many around us were celebrating Valentine's Day with hearts, but ours were broken without you. We missed you in March. We saw shamrocks and leprechauns and remembered you were our pot of gold. We missed you in April as spring arrived and snows receded. We missed you in May as we celebrated Mother's Day. We missed you in June as spring became summer. Fathers were celebrated.
We missed you in July, through red, white, and blue, through cookouts, fireworks, and parades. All we wanted was to hug you. We missed you in August, with the sun shining and the water sparkling blue. We missed you in September, as students began a school year anew. Then came October, with leaves falling and jack-o'-lanterns all around. We missed you then too. Turkeys in November made us cry again. We are so thankful to have known and loved you for as long as we had together. But your chair at our table will be empty forevermore.
In December, holiday decorations were displayed as the year wound down. I looked for you everywhere, but you weren't to be found. And so one year ends and another begins anew. In our hearts, you will remain. We loved you once, we love you still. We always have, we always will.
As we see these 12 lit candles, we are reminded of our loved ones lost to cancer and those battling it still, and those who have fought and defeated the disease. Please hold up your luminaria at this time for everyone to see. The names on the papers you've created have those of the loved ones we relay for. Our mothers, sisters, fathers, brothers, aunts, uncles, grandparents, children, friends, and family members. Please swipe left on your phone so you can see all the luminaria here today. Please let us take a moment of silence to remember them all.
We all have our different reasons to relay and why we are here, but we all have one thing in common. We want to fight back against cancer. Let us now let the luminaria shine and reflect on the memories that will last through every month of the year as we take a lap together from our homes. Take your phones along the walk with you and any of your family members that is with you right now while listening to some inspiration by Taylor Swift.
The buttons of my coat were tangled in my hair. In doctor's office lighting, I didn't tell you I was scared. That was the first time we were there. Holy orange bottles, each night I pray to you. Desperate people find faith, so now I pray to Jesus too. And I say to you, ooh, soon you'll get better. Ooh, soon you'll get better. Ooh, you'll get better soon. 'Cause you have to. I know delusion when I see it in the mirror. You like the nicer nurses. You make the best of a bad deal. I just pretend it isn't real. I'll paint the kitchen neon. I'll brighten up the sky. I know I'll never get it. There's not a day that I won't try. I'll say to you, ooh, soon you'll get better. Ooh, soon you'll get better. Ooh, you'll get better soon. 'Cause you have to. And I hate to make this all about me. But who am I supposed to talk to? What am I supposed to do? Won't go back to normal if it ever was. It's been years of hoping, and I keep saying it because I have to. Ooh, you'll get better. Ooh, soon you'll get better. Ooh, you'll get better soon. Get better, 'cause you have to.
Thanks, Jaden and Jessica, and for all of those who are honoring, supporting, and remembering today. Now for some fun. Let's play a little movie Kahoot. Go to kahoot.it on your Chromebook, your computer, or your iPad, or even on your phone if you know how to do it. I'm going to share the game pin with you once again. I'll give everybody a few minutes to join, and then we'll have some fun. I'm going to give everybody one more minute to join, and then we'll get started. Let's get started. Remember, you could still join the Kahoot while we're still playing.
High School Musical is the correct answer. We're All in This Together is the final song in High School Musical 1. All for One is the final song in High School Musical 2. And Now or Never is the opening song in High School Musical 3.
Great job, Leah.
The correct answer is Weepy, as all others are dwarves, including Doc, who is the head dwarf in the movie Snow White.
Ooh, up 19 places. Sarah is the highest climber, but Leah is still holding on to her lead.
Jason is not the killer in the original Friday the 13th. It's actually his mother, Mrs. Voorhees, and the others are all killers in other movies.
Ooh, Stephen has taken the lead, but Kaylee is up 13 places.
The correct answer is Lord Farquaad, as he is a character in Shrek, which is not a movie made by Disney.
Stephen is still holding on to his lead, but Mia is up 8 places this time.
Taxi Driver is the correct response, as Robert De Niro is not an actor in any of the other movies listed.
Ooh, Steven is on fire with an answer streak of 5.
The correct answer was true. In the ending sequence, it shows Rose as she passes away in her sleep and reunites with Jack in the afterlife.
That was a good, tricky question. Steven's still holding on to his lead, but Sarah is bumping up.
Come and Get Love is the correct response, as it is played in the opening credits while the other songs are played throughout the movie.
Seven places up for Alan Williams, but Steven is still holding on to a strong lead. Nicole and Emily Dunn are moving their way up though.
Mary Poppins is the correct answer. She plays the titular character, which means the movie is actually named after her character.
Kara Miller is up 4 places, but Steven is still holding on to his lead, but Sarah is jumping up the leaderboard.
The answer is true. Joker has a worldwide gross of over $1 billion, which is $200 million higher than the second highest grossing R-rated movie.
Mia is our highest climber this time, up 6 places. Steven is still holding on to his lead, but Sarah, Kara Miller, and April are jumping up the leaderboard.
Luke's home planet has 2 suns, named Tatoo 1 and Tatoo 2.
We are halfway through our movie Kahoot. Steven is still holding his lead. Lori and Tony and Emily Dunn are climbing up the leaderboard. And John Simons has the highest climber award this time for up 7 places. Keep up the great work.
Buddy the Elf puts a chocolate Pop-Tart in his breakfast spaghetti.
Marie and Tony have a highest streak of 4 answers in a row, and they bump themselves up to second place, but Steven is still holding on to a strong lead.
The answer is false. The film he won Best Director for was actually Schindler's List.
Still keeping the same leaderboard. Steven in first, Tony and Lori in second, Kaylee third, Emily Dunn fourth, and Sarah fifth.
La La Land was incorrectly announced as Best Picture winner. It was actually Moonlight that won Best Picture at the 2017 Academy Awards.
Mia gets the highest climber award this time, up 4 places, but Steven is still in the lead.
That answer is false. The highest grossing movie of all time was actually Avengers Endgame.
4 players just hit an answer streak of 3. Great job. Steven still holding on to his lead. Kaylee, Emily, and Sarah jump up the leaderboard to 2nd, 3rd, and 4th place.
The correct answer is Bing Bong, which was the name of Riley's imaginary friend when she was a little girl.
Steven's making a comeback with 3 answers correct in a row, and Nicole is heading up the leaderboard.
American Sniper is the highest grossing war movie of all time with over $540 million.
John Simons jumps up 5 places for the highest climber award. Emily jumps herself into 2nd, Nicole in 3rd, and Lori and Tony are back on the leaderboard.
The answer is true. The cure for insomnia has a runtime of around 87 hours.
Steven has the highest climber award, and Emily is still in 2nd. Kaylee jumps up to 3rd. Bria jumps up to the leaderboard in 4th, and Nicole in 5th.
The Incredibles was the first Pixar movie with a rating higher than G. The rating was PG, and it was said to be because of action sequences.
Another answer streak of 3 for John Simons. Bria bumped up to 3rd place. Lori and Tony are now on the leaderboard in 5th place, but Steven is still holding on to his lead. But Emily Dunn is coming pretty close.
The correct answer is true. They used this material even though several years prior it had been determined asbestos could cause health issues.
Mia's making a comeback with three correct in a row. Steven is still holding on to his first place lead. Emily Dunn in second, Bria third, Kaylee fourth, Lori and Tony in fifth as we go into our final Kahoot question. Here we go.
"47 hours is the correct answer. Each frame is 1/24th of a second long, which is why the movie takes so long to create.
Way to go, Bria. Way to go, Emily Dunn. Congratulations, Steven, you came in first. And runners up, Nicole and Sarah. Thanks for playing, everybody. We hope you enjoyed it. Now on to our fight back ceremony with Tom.
Thank you. There is hope even in the most difficult times. Today and every day, we commit to supporting and honoring all who have been affected by cancer. Every moment matters, and so does every volunteer. Thank you to all of you who choose to fight cancer each and every day. During this time, the American Cancer Society couldn't be prouder of their volunteers, donors, employees, and entire communities for the way in which they are working together to keep everyone safe and well cared for. Together, we will get through this. And cancer won't stop, and neither will we. At this time, please hold up your hashtag #WhyIRelay sign and swipe left on your phone to see why everyone is here today. Every day we will continue to celebrate our cancer survivors, remember our loved ones lost, and fight back against cancer. We are asking you one last time after the event is over to please post a picture of yourself and your hashtag #WhyIRelay sign on your social media, along with the link to your fundraising page. Only working together can we help put an end to this disease. Thank you. Now to Mrs. Bauman for some recognition and final thoughts.
Thanks, Tom. And again, don't forget, if we get to our $20,000 goal, myself and Mrs. Ozemnik will be pied in the face live on Facebook. Now for our closing ceremonies. I want to start by thanking each and every one of you who has joined us here today. Your dedication to this cause is astonishing, and I'm so grateful to be part of this with you. And for those of you who couldn't be here with us today as well, thank you for all of your help and support throughout this year. Now I would like to recognize our top fundraising teams. In fifth place, we have Shrek Cancer with a total of $727 raised. Congratulations. In fourth place, we have Cancer in Custody with $735 raised. Nice job. In third place, we have Up with the Cure with a total of $783 raised. Close race here. Good job. In second place, we have A Walk to Remember with a total of $1,224 raised. Great job, everyone. And our first place team this year is Cancer Can't Sit With Us with a total raised of $2,338. Please give yourselves a great round of applause. Thank you to all of our wonderful teams. Now for our top individual fundraisers. In fifth place, we have Isabella Latona with $270 raised. Great job, Isabella. In fourth place, we have Caitlin Downey with $300 raised. Congratulations, great job. In third place, we have Sean Connors with $319.83 raised. Great job. In second place, we have Isabella Mancini with $363.21 raised. Great job, Isabella. And our top fundraiser this year, again, I believe is Miss Eleni Alfano with $1,325.95 raised. Great job. Congratulations to everybody that has raised money for this great cause. I also want to give a little shout out to Russell Keeler, who is a huge supporter of our event and a Pittston area alumni. He has raised $400 for our event as well. So I just wanted to give him a little shout out and thank him for all that he has done for our event over this year as well. Again, congratulations to everyone and thank you everyone for coming here today. We're going to end our event by taking one last lap together to celebrate all that we have accomplished and continue to do in the future. I hope you stay healthy and safe. Thank you for participating. Enjoy the rest of the weekend and don't stop believing that you can make a difference in the fight against cancer.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
A singer in a smoky room. I smell wine and cheap perfume. For a smile they can share the night. It goes on and on and on.
Thanks everyone again for coming. You all did a fabulous job. I hope you enjoyed the rest of your weekend.
And I think you all need to give Mrs. Ballin a round of applause for all that she's done for this great group of students, for all you do. She's worked so hard and she's so proud of all of you. Her willingness to get pied, I hope we can raise some money. She deserves lots of props, and I'm proud of what you guys have done. Way to go, Mrs. Bauman and Mr. Lezevnik, for supporting your students.
Thanks, dear. Thanks, everybody. It was great to see all your beautiful, shining faces. I miss seeing all of you. Have a great rest of your day.